Ubiquity finally gave MSPs what we've been asking for. Full control of Unifi OS on our own hardware, no licensing fees, no vendor lock-ins, and yes, it's official. Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO of DPC Technology. I've got a cool one today. Today we're going to talk about the new Unifi OS server. As I've mentioned in earlier videos, we are migrating our clients at DPC Technology over to Unifi Gateways. And part of that process is to get everybody into the new ecosystem. And that's why this software is so awesome for us. There is going to be a time while we're doing this migration over the next few years where half of our clients are going to be in some other system and half of our clients are going to be in Unifi. So what this is going to allow us to do is to deploy Unifi OS server into those environments that don't already have a Unifi Gateway. And that way we can have all of our clients have the same experience. So you may be saying, hey, Clay, that's great, but haven't we already been able to self-host a Unifi network? And that may be true, but there are some huge advantages here with this new Unifi OS server. So let me jump in real quick here, and I'm just reading from the release notes here. The benefits of Unifi OS server compared to self-hosting the network application. Opting for a Unifi OS server provides several advantages over simply running the standalone Unifi network application. Full control of the OS experience. Enjoy the comprehensive and unified OS interface, providing a consistent management experience similar to that found on official Unifi consoles. Built on the Unifi OS foundation, this self-hosted solution is better positioned to support new features, updates, and upcoming Unifi applications, offering greater extensibility. Unified updates. Manage updates for the underlying Unifi OS and its applications through a more integrated process. That's great, but I think the real power here is that we're going to be able to run this server OS on our own hardware, meaning it doesn't need a connection to the internet. And then if we want global management or be able to control it remotely, we can hook it into Site Manager and then have all of our sites in one global interface. So let's jump into the software real quick. So I'm going to install this on my Windows PC. There are also going to be Mac and Linux versions. I will leave a link to download all the different versions here in the description. So here we are. I already ran the Windows installer. It did have a couple next, and it did install some dependencies, but it was all an automated process, just like anything else. There's not really much to see there. Once it was installed, I did have to do a reboot. And once I rebooted, I clicked on the icon and I came to this. Down here, you'll see the option to restore from backup. This is really cool to be able to do. One of the things that Unifi is really good is being able to restore from different consoles. So what I'm assuming we're going to be able to do here is back up this once we're done. And let's just say we migrated from having no console on site to say, let's say we got an EFG at the site. I'm assuming we're going to be able to restore that backup from server OS onto that EFG, which would be awesome. Also, just having backup is great. The other cool thing about this, obviously for us, we are going to be running this most likely in a VM. And being able to migrate those VMs very simply and easily is, and for us, that's just another layer of management ease, being able to back up that VM and restore it really quickly and be able to move that around. But you do have the restore from backup option here, which obviously means we're going to be able to back this up later. I'm going to give this a new name and we're going to go Clay Home. And I'm going to go next. And it's going to say create a UI account. I already have one. I'm going to go ahead and sign into that. It's got a few notes here. I will say resale, is strictly prohibitive. You might want to check with the way that you are using your global management or you're charging for your clients here to make sure that you're not violating anything there. But for us, we probably are not. So I'm going to go, okay, I understand. And I'm going to go sign in. And it's going to give me 2-factor authentication on my phone. And it's going to then ask me again to restore from backup. And it's probably going to give me some of my... Yes, you can see here, it's got several options that I can choose to restore from. I've got a UCG5 or UDR, EFG. These are all different routers that I've had and backed up. So I could restore from a certain backup point. UCG5, I could restore it from a few days ago. So I'm gonna continue without backup, but as I mentioned before, Ubiquity's done a really good job of being able to restore these things from one device to another. You're seeing all these different devices. These are all different devices. And the ability to restore from one device to another has been really cool. So I'm assuming once we do this and we get a backup of this installed OS version that we will be able to then restore it to a console in the future if we do add a console to that site, which would be huge because obviously, you know, it may be 6 months to 2 years before we get to a site to upgrade them off their existing router. And in that time, we'll probably have done some things. We'll probably have a complex network set up there. And the ability to just restore will be awesome and save a ton of time. So I'm going to continue without backup. And we will wait while it installs. It says about 1 minute. And so now it says we're good to go, and I can go to my dashboard. And here we go. It looks just like all of your dashboards on your Unifi devices. Now, I don't have anything here that is ready to be adopted because I am actually running UCG Fiber here, and all of my things are adopted into that. But I'm assuming that it's going to run just like that, and I can just adopt my devices right in here, which is pretty amazing. And the other cool thing about this that just showed up is now that I have this console in my site manager. So I'm able to go into my site manager where all of my devices are, and it then just shows up and I can remotely manage this along with all of the other devices that are there. Really awesome stuff. And if you go into settings and go into control plane, I just wanted to show people in the control plane what you get with OS server. So Unifi OS server, you can see up to date, it's 4.2.23. You get network and you get interspace. I have not installed Spinner interspace, but if you wanted to, you could. But what you don't get here is the other applications. Just want to be clear on what you get. This is the latest official release version of network, which is 9.3.43, which just basically means you will be running the latest version of network and interspace on Unifi OS server. You can also see here, it's got Unifi ID endpoint. In control plane, beyond the updates, you have integrations, backups, console, and push notifications. You also get logs and alarm manager, just like you would in the regular version. Obviously, when I was trying to build out a new network here, I would have a bunch of devices. They would auto detect and be able to adopt here, and I would be able to control them all in Unifi OS server. This is really awesome for us because it's going to allow us to manage all those clients that didn't necessarily have a Unifi console with the new server OS, which is amazing. I'm going to quickly read a couple more blurbs from their release here. Unifi is built on a license-free philosophy powered by Unifi OS at the core of Unifi gateways. While most cloud solutions in the industry require every device to be tethered to a cloud licensing server, Unifi takes a different path. With Unifi OS, each site gets a fast, private, local control plane. No internet or cloud required. Then with Unifi Site Manager, you're getting secure cloud connectivity, enabling features like global admin access and SD-WAN creation across all your sites. Today, we're excited to introduce Windows OS Server, a new self-hosted option designed specifically for MSPs. Now you can deploy Unifi OS on your own hardware and still get the full Unifi experience. That includes access to our latest technologies, Interspace, Site Magic, SD-WAN, Global Admin Tools, Centralized Update Management, and even Unifi Identity, our rapidly growing zero trust networking platform. Unifi OS Server is the evolution of Unifi Network Server, and it integrates seamlessly with Unifi Site Manager, giving MSPs a unified experience whether sites are self-hosted or powered by native Unifi consoles. So this is another big step in the right direction for Unifi, especially MSPs like me who want to use Unifi in their deployments. The ability to self-host this, license-free, no dependencies on the internet, these are all big features for us. And ultimately, this license-free model frees up budget for us to spend that on things that are more important to the client, like import protection and SIM, and things that are going to move the needle on their security stance. What's even cooler than that is you'll be able to play with them in the sandbox here of this Unifi OS server, get everything exactly the way you want it, and if you do want to migrate that to a console, you'll be able to back up these configs and then restore them to a console. So I think there's probably some use case for this beyond just the typical MSP as well. And for the average IT guy, maybe has multiple networks set up, maybe at a friend's house, your parents' house, that kind of stuff. The ability to be able to do this without having a console on site is really cool as well. So if you're an MSP or an IT provider and you want to keep up to date with these updates as they come out, there are more of these updates coming down the pipeline. Please like and subscribe. Also, leave any comments or questions down below. I try to get to all of those. And as always, we'll see you guys in the next video.